Let's talk about postfix completion. Postfix completion is one of those features in IntelliJ IDEA that I think doesn't necessarily come naturally to Java developers to start to use, but when you do get to use it, it's really cool. Let me show you what I mean. Let's create a new generator. Okay. Then we can type dot and we can type var, and that will then assign the new generator to a new variable. That's what I mean by postfix completion. So the completion is at the end of the thing that you just tried to do something with. So you'll see that what we did, let's do it again. What we did is we typed something at the end of our expression, but it put something back at the beginning of the expression. And that's why postfix completion is cool, because it allows you to keep typing forward rather than having to move your caret back to the beginning of the expression. Let me show you another example of this. Let's go to here, and in here I want to say if sout.is empty, but I actually want to say not empty. So I can use postfix completion to say not. Now, granted, that's more typing than if I had just added an exclamation mark at the beginning of the expression. But the point is, I didn't need to move my cursor back to the beginning of that expression to add the exclamation mark. I just carried on typing forwards. It made the change back at the beginning of the expression and then kept my caret back where it was before. I'll show you another example of where this might be cool. So I find this really helpful for what would be a good example here. Let's take a look at row, let's say, let's do dot and let's say cast. And then casting is always a little bit awkward in Java. Casting is sometimes a sign of a smell, but casting is awkward to type because you have to go back to the beginning of the expression. You have to put the cast inside brackets, then put, if you want to call anything on that, then you need to put all of that inside brackets as well. So it's a bit of typing and a bit of messing around. Whereas if you use postfix completion to cast, it does all of that for you. So let's say, what do we want to cast this to? Let's cast it to a list. Fine. And then, so you'll see, it took my caret, it put the braces in, took my caret back to the beginning so I could type the type, then it brings my caret back to the end so I can carry on doing what it was I was trying to do before. So postfix completion just allows us to carry on doing stuff, keep typing, keep moving forwards. If you want to see all of the things which are, all the postfix completion things which are available, you type dot after your thing, press up. So normally, pressing dot will give you this code completion dropdown, and obviously you can go down and have a look for the method you want. But if instead you go up, you see all the postfix completion options available, which are basically at the bottom of that list of things. So you can do things like, you can use it to wrap something in a lambda, you can check to see if it's null or not null, you can wrap it in an optional. All of these things are basically ways to either wrap your thing in something else or put something at the beginning of your expression. So again, like I say, you just keep typing forwards. Have a play with postfix completion, because I think you'll find it changes the way that you write code and allows you to keep thinking forward of the thing you're trying to achieve instead of thinking about the specific bits of syntax that you're trying to type into your code.